fire tragedy. A body is discovered as an inferno destroys a home in Melbourne's north. We're live from the scene.
Qantas emergency, 15 passengers injured, one person taken to hospital after a mid-air drama on a flight to Hong Kong.
Bring the games to Victoria. Regional Victoria will launch a bid this morning to host the 2030 Commonwealth Games. We have all the detail.
Car insurance rip-off, the shocking ways you could be paying too much for your premiums and how to avoid being stung.
A Bourne emergency, how Matt Damon's Byron Bay holiday with Chris Hemsworth turned into a triple zero nightmare.
I'm addicted to you.
Are you addicted to social media? We reveal the surprising new ways you can control your family screen time.
And from dark to milk, bunnies to mini eggs, it's your ultimate Easter egg audit for every price and taste, and it's excellent. Hope you all saw what I did there. Good morning to you. It is Thursday, the 13th of April. I'm allowed to do it once at the beginning of the show, aren't I?
What's that?
Well, excellent. A bad pun.
Yeah, I think you'll do it again.
Do you think so?
I'll put money on you doing it again.
All right, we'll see. Got 3.5 hours to be restrained.
Timmy, she's no chance of getting through, is she?
I wouldn't give her 20 minutes. As much as I love her. How many people work on this day? How many people try to get out of work?
Oh, the early
Thursday,
really?
Yeah,
Friday.
The early sickie.
It's like everyone's just getting ready,
hitting the road.
Yeah.
And with that, there's plenty of sport about. I'll tell you about it this morning.
Great. Look forward to it.
Be careful on the road. Slow down. Don't do anything nuts.
And double demerits as well.
News to kick things off this morning with Alicia. Hey, Alicia.
Hey, Ben. Good morning to you, Lisa. Morning, Timmy. And morning to you at home as well. We begin this morning in Melbourne, where a man has died in a fire which engulfed a bungalow at Thomastown in the city's north. Let's go live now to reporter Melanie Slade for more details on this. Morning to you, Mel. A grim discovery for fire crews. All right, Mel Slade in Melbourne, thank you.
The search for a missing teenage bushwalker will resume at first light in Sydney South today. The 19-year-old woman reportedly became separated from her partner in the Royal National Park at Bundina, and she failed to return to their meeting point. A search last night failed to find her. That search will continue this morning. Detectives are appealing for information after the murder of a Chinese national, Quinn Wu, who was shot at a home in Sydney Southwest back in February. Mr Wu died at the property in Guildford. It was being used as a temple at the time. But police believe he was not the intended target and may have been trying to break up a fight. Officers suspect another person may have been injured in the attack, and they're calling for that person to come forward.
An outbreak of Legionnaires' disease in Melbourne, which left 5 people seriously ill, is believed to have been spread through air conditioning units. 3 men and 2 women all reported working or visiting the CBD in the days before they became sick in March as well as the start of April. They have all now been released from hospital. A number of cooling towers in the area have been disinfected as a precaution.
US Secretary of State Rex Tillerson has admitted America-Russia relations are at a low point moments after meeting with Vladimir Putin. For the details, let's cross to Nine's US Bureau Chief Robert Penfold. Rob, good morning. What did the pair discuss in that meeting?
Now, we're also going to hear from President Trump today. He's meeting now with the leaders of NATO in Washington, and so we expect him also to address that worsening situation in Syria. Lisa?
Okay, Rob, thanks very much.
Okay, let's take a look at the markets for you now this Thursday morning. And on Wall Street, the Dow Jones is lower in late trade, down 55 points. The S&P 500 also down. At home, the All Ords closed the day marginally higher yesterday. On Asian markets, Japan's Shanghai Composite is down 15 points. And in Hong Kong, the Hang Seng up 225. Let's take a look at commodities. Oh, sorry, I've missed the London FTSE.
Oh, no.
I know. I'm surprised you didn't pull me up on that, guys.
Wow.
Well, we remained hopeful that it would happen.
Yes. Ross Greenwood will be horrified.
Hopefully he's not watching. Down 13 points. There you go. There you go, everyone wondering about the FTSE. 2 commodities markets now, and the gold price, $1,275 an ounce. The oil price is sitting at $53 a barrel, and the Aussie dollar this morning, for all of you lucky travellers, if you're heading off, it is down, mate, down against the majors, it is at 74 US cents.
Not so lucky.
Exactly.
Good recovery.
Better for us. There you go. All right, an unexpected ferry visitor has crashed a baseball game in Miami, stopping play as it ran onto the field. Take a look at this. The cat dodged players and ground staff as they tried to comfort the animal.
Who knew cat claws could dig their way into a plasma?
Yeah.
Exactly. Nothing they can't do.
Good on you.
Well done, pussycat. All right. That cat, not... I wasn't calling you a pussycat.
I don't mind. I don't mind, Lisa.
It's not a bad nickname, actually.
We know each other well enough.
Thanks, pussycat.
Thanks, pussycat.
Let's take a look at the weather around the country. Brisbane, you've got a partly cloudy day today and a high of 27. Sydney, a morning shower or two to 23. And in Darwin, where yesterday they had the coldest day, or the third coldest day it was, in 1,000 years, or something like that. but it was really, really, really cold. It got down to 28 degrees. It's going to be 31, so situation almost normal, and a possible storm. That's situation normal. Okay, what's happening in sport,
Tim? It's brilliant they've had records for that long. It was quite amazing. But I'll tell you what's new, pussycat. Coming up, he's a man in demand. Richmond want to keep him. Hardwick reveals his plan to stay Dustin Martin at Richmond. He's been superb this year. Also ahead, do you stay or do you go? Uncle Benny warns Mitchell Moses about leaving the Tigers.
And you'll never guess who's got some easy money up for grabs. Don't go anywhere because Blocky is on deck today and you could be a major winner.
Welcome back to the show. Time now for a look at today's front pages. And 9news.com leads with an investigation into a Qantas flight after 15 passengers were injured after one of their jets suffered a so-called stick shaker warning mid-flight.
What about this? The Bourne emergency. Brisbane's Courier Mail is reporting that Hollywood action hero Matt Damon came to his daughter's rescue on a Byron Bay holiday alongside the Hemsworth family.
So Chris Hemsworth and Matt Damon are besties?
Yeah, holidaying at Byron.
Gee.
They slipped under the radar until now.
Certainly did. Wowee. All right, well, one of the hardest decisions we'll all have to make this week, let's face it, is what Easter eggs to buy the family. A little later in the show, we're going to do an audit.
An audit?
Yeah, on Easter eggs. But before we get into that, we wanted to know your favourites.
Yeah, Kay's in Melbourne. She's a fan of the lint bunnies. She says, if you're counting, I've purchased 4 as prezzies for the kids. I've also consumed... said 4. Hard to resist.
Holly loves the Malteser bunnies. She reckons there's something about them that just makes them taste so much better than normal Maltesers.
It's delicious. Interesting. We also asked our viewers their thoughts on the upcoming federal budget. We didn't really get many responses, but on the Easter eggs, a lot of responses.
Overwhelming.
So, favourite Easter eggs. Timmy, you're the resident guru.
I love anything Cadbury, but I mean, it's all about size at Easter time.
Okay, so there's my favourite right there.
Yeah.
Don't believe what anyone tells you. Size does matter.
That's fantastic.
Look at that. That's serious.
Alicia, come on.
Oh, anything dark chocolate. So I've got an old gold bunny here from Cadbury.
Is that a health conscious decision?
No, it's a taste decision.
Okay.
All right, we're going to reveal ours a little bit later.
I know, everyone will be on the edge of their seats waiting for that news.
Right.
So let's go to the news right now with Alicia.
Thank you very much for that, Ben. We begin in Melbourne, where a man has died in a fire which engulfed a bungalow in the city's north. Neighbours were woken to a loud explosion at Thomastown and alerted fire crews. The body of a male believed to be in his 50s was found inside. Police are currently investigating. To some breaking news out of Sydney, and two people have just been charged with assaulting a grandfather who was walking home from the Royal Easter Show. The 65-year-old was set upon by two people near Riverston train station before his attackers returned with more people to help hit the man. They are expected to face court later today. Well, action star Matt Damon may have fought aliens in his movies, but he's now experienced how dangerous Australian wildlife can be. The American actor had been holidaying with friend Chris Hemsworth in Byron Bay when his daughter was stung by a jellyfish. Damon rushed to a nearby cafe to get some ice. So there you go. Coming to the rescue.
Don't you love it?
It's just a part of summer, isn't it, growing up in Australia? Mm. Jellyfish stings, unfortunately.
It is, but it just looks even more dramatic when you have real action heroes coming to the
rescue.
Exactly. I hope it hasn't turned Matt Damon off. coming back to Australia.
No, I hope not.
Because that would be a disaster.
Yeah, I'm sure the Hemsworths can convince them to come back.
He got
through Mars pretty well, so...
That's true.
He's out of shape, that Hemsworth, isn't he? Have a look at the arms.
Oh, look, he's gone to seed, but that's okay. We'll accept him when he gets back to normal. Thanks a lot, Alicia. Coming up, we meet the amazing performance painter who's created artworks of some of the world's biggest stars in just a matter of minutes. It's amazing. Wait until you see his impressive skill. Plus, pay off your credit card, take a holiday and spend up big. Stick around to see if you're our winner in our cash call this morning. How good would it be just in time for the long weekend?
When you say to people that you're restoring somebody's sight with a tooth, it sounds crazy.
Easter Sunday at 7. A 60 minutes you have to see to believe.
It did sound crazy to us too.
In one of the weirdest breakthroughs of our time.
You worried about scaring the grandkids?
Saving John's sight with a tooth.
Miracle. Oh.
60 minutes, Easter Sunday at 7.
Welcome back to the show. Time now for sport. Here's Tim.
Just a small tip. If you get one of these lovely Cadbury rabbits, and there's a lot of different ways to break it open, yeah. The best thing is to go...
Oh, yeah.
And then that allows everything to be eaten nice and simply.
I think that was meant to go back to the shop, Tim. Mm.
Oh, well.
It was good technique,
thank
though.
Could you lent me $5.
Right, Tim.
So there we go.
Lisa,
do you want
his right out in my No, I'm not, because I haven't had my breakfast yet. And I find if I start the day with chocolate... Which
you
I
end the day with chocolate.
Was known to do when the kids were little, because it gets a girl through. Then I eat chocolate for the rest of the day.
Yeah.
Because you get that sweet taste.
Exactly.
Natalia Cooper might be listening into this just thinking, am I going to be doing my weather anytime soon?
This is the third snake I have touched in a week. I'm becoming a snake wrangler. Ben and Lisa. Mm.
It's impressive.
This is the biggest one though.
Good on you, Natalia.
Oh, and it's called Fluffy.
Very out there for Thursday. Thanks a lot. We'll see you soon. Now, coming up, struggling to find a babysitter your children actually like? We're going to meet the Aussie mum of two who is making it easier than ever before.
It's like Tinder for babysitters.
And up next, we're kicking Good Friday footy off with our drop kicks. James Bracey, Rugby League, Nathan Brown, AFL. It's on the way in just a tick.
On A Current Affair, the special consumer road test for every Aussie woman. New season styles on the market, all at budget prices. How your favourite jeans stack up on fit, quality and price.
This is very good value for money. This is a really good quality jean.
A Current Affair tonight.
Great to have your company on Holy Thursday, Easter week, can you believe it? And it's that week, that time of the week again where we're doing the drop kicks. AFL legend Nathan Brown is in Melbourne, James Bracey in the house. Start with you, Brownie. Collingwood, a narrow win last week over Sydney. Are they getting it together? Is the Queen Mary turning?
Oh, I wouldn't be getting too excited if I was the black and white army just yet. I think West Coast Eagles kick off with a big win against Sydney tonight. Then the Dogs on Good Friday, Melbourne, GWS.
All righty. Thank you, Nathan. Some interesting results so far this year. Let's have a look at the rugby league. James, Good Friday footy is a tradition in rugby league.
No slapping in the NRL anymore. Got banned as of yesterday. You get sin bin. So no more slapping.
No more slapping. Yeah, we're quietening the whole game down. It's probably a good thing in a lot of ways. Look, great to see you on the coverage. Great to have you here on the Today Show. James Bracey doing and nailing the wide world of sports job. And Nathan Brown in Melbourne. It's a big weekend of footy, no matter what code you are watching, Lisa and Benny.
That is very true. Thanks a lot for that, Tim. Well, coming up, car insurance rip-off. The shocking ways you could be paying too much for your premiums and how to avoid getting stung. And how good would some extra cash be this Easter long weekend? Stick around for our cash call coming up a little later this morning. Today could be your lucky day.
Guess who's back again? Cyclone Debbie has affected so many lives.
The destruction in North Queensland, right down to flooding here in the southeast, has left homes and communities devastated.
They now need strength and support.
We always stick together during the toughest of times. Come on, Queensland, give what you can.
Donate online or text the word Debbie to this number. It's nights like these that'll make us
Welcome back to the show and a very good morning to everyone in Brisbane on this Thursday morning. A bit of cloud about for you today, heading for a high of 27 degrees.
Bit of Aussie hip-hop for you, Lisa. Rise and shine, Melbourne. There's some fog this morning, isn't there ever? The sun is going to come out, though, a little later on. 23 degrees the top for you today. Righto, let's have a look at the Gold Coast. Come on, Gold Coast. Possible shower. 26 degrees the top, but it's always nice.
Doesn't look too bad. A few people will be heading there for the Easter break, I'm sure. Welcome back to the show. Time now for some sport.
Let's start off with the AFL, and despite pulling off a massive upset win over the Swans last week, today shows Nathan Brown is not convinced that Collingwood is going to play finals footy. He, in fact, says they won't. The Magpies will be at almost full strength when they play Alicia St Kilda on Sunday. Cameron McAvoy has shaken off his demons from Rio after defeating Olympic champion Kyle Chalmers. 15-year-old Kaylee McKeon, who came second, also qualified for the World Championships. 15 years of age. Tell me she doesn't have a wonderful future.
Yeah, name to watch. Mm. Thanks a lot, Tim.
Good on you, Timmy. Thank you. Let's have a look at what's happening with the weather right around Australia. Natalia.
Behind part of the spider, the bigger.
Oh, what?
The more likely it is that it's a female.
They're sort of the Kardashian. And
that's spider just nature.
It's the males that are six times more toxic. So it's the males.
And they also eat their males as well. Yeah. They eat their males after mating. That's what funnel webs do.
There's a lesson in that for you boys. Right there.
That's why they're bigger.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Natalia.
Welcome to our world.
Coming up.
I'm not mentioning Dickie.
The new technology claiming to help you find relief from those dreaded migraines without radiation. The medicine cabinet, but how does it work and does it work? We'll find out.
And get this, why did two Hollywood A-list superstars have to get help on the beach? What? Entertainment news is coming right up. Jellyfish.
To you, Brisbane, looking absolutely stunning right now. There'll be a little bit of cloud that'll make its way across the city skies, and you're heading for a top of 27 degrees.
Gold Coast, possible shower today, 26 degrees. Hope you have a nice one heading into the Easter long weekend.
Right now, it's time for the Money Minute. Good morning to you, Ross.
Good morning to you, Lisa. Good morning, everyone. Now, listen, do you want to know how hard it is to do the federal budget due in less than 4 weeks' time? In the Treasury offices in Canberra, that old SAP finance modelling system must have steam coming out of it right now with all the different scenarios and moving parts. Here's just one chart to show you how tough it is. This is the iron ore price. Over the past year, the low point in May last year was $48 a tonne. The high point, nearly $95 on February 21 this year. That jumped 98% in just 10 months. Now, back to Langton Crescent Treasury. You can see the steam coming out of the offices there. The problem, the wild swing in iron ore price, is that every $10 rise or fall in iron ore represents $2.5 billion a year in tax revenue. Overnight, the price fell another 8.5%, $6.34 to $68. That represents around $1.5 billion in tax revenue. That's just overnight. Now, to be fair, government and Treasury don't ride the dips and troughs of iron ore. They generally pick a conservative number, last year around $45 a tonne, and budget from there, which is an improvement on what previous even Coalition and Labor governments did. They assume very high figures for iron ore and spent accordingly. And that's largely why we're in the financial mess we're in today. Let's have a quick look at the markets this morning and what we can see. The dollar under 75 US cents. Let's move it forward again and we can see on commodity markets, gold prices up $1.13 US an ounce overnight. The Dow Jones Index of US shares right now is off by almost 58 points. It's closed right now. And yesterday, the All Ordinaries Index of Australian shares, well, it was up by 4 points. Time now for entertainment news with Richard Wilkins.
Good morning again. Thank you, Ross. Well, two of Hollywood's most bankable stars, Matt Damon and Chris Hemsworth, were forced to call an ambulance at Byron Bay yesterday as their two families were enjoying a day at the beach. Matt's six-year-old daughter, Stella, suffered a nasty sting from a jellyfish. Enjoy the rest of the holidays, gang, and hope you're feeling better, Stella. And also congratulations to Jimmy Barnes, who wound up his triumphant working-class boy tour last night.
It is so beautifully, brilliantly and heartbreaking. Well written.
Yeah, it's wonderful.
It's a great present. It's a great thing to keep yourself.
His son Jackie on stage playing piano and drums, Mahalia singing, Ben, son-in-law playing guitar, yeah. David, family affair, awesome show. Congratulations, yeah. Jim. Well done.
Well done, Jimmy.
Well done to Barnsey. Right now it's 7 o'clock and it's time for the news. Here are the top stories on today.
And a very very good morning to you. Great to have your company on this Thursday, the 13th of April. And we begin in Melbourne, where more than 20 firefighters battling an inferno in the city's north have made a grim discovery. Live now to Melanie Slade, who's first at the scene at Thomastown for us. Mel, what more can you tell us? Okay, Melanie Slade, thank you.
If you are a single male who drives a red car and you bought your vehicle insurance at night time, it's likely you're paying a lot more for your cover. Let's go live now to Lauren Ginoli in Canberra for more on this. Lauren, some of the insurance industry's secrets have been revealed. All right, Lauren Ginoli in Canberra, thank you.
Well, in a world first, regional Victoria has this morning announced a bid that would see the 2030 Commonwealth Games held in not one, but 11 regional cities across the state. Let's go to Mayor Dinny Adam of the Greater Shepparton Council. A first of its kind approach to the Games. It could change the way we view major sporting events.
Indeed, it will change the way that we view sporting events into the future.
Well, on a practical level, talk us through how it would work.
I think Victoria is probably the only, well, the best suited state in Australia to actually host this type of event. Logistically, we're very compact compared to the other states, obviously. Our population also assists us with this plan. So we're very confident that this actually can work and will work.
Well, obviously, the idea is also to promote local tourism. And on that level, we hope it works.
No
Dinny,
doubt.
Thank you very much for your time this morning.
No, holiday thank makers you. Around the country will take to the roads this Easter long weekend. Some are starting already. So when is the cheapest time to fill up your car? Peter Currie from the NRMA joins us now. Does it change depending on where you are around Australia?
Oh, absolutely.
Have a good one. Thanks, Pete.
Thank you, Ben. Two full weeks of strikes affecting Medicare, Centrelink and child support payments begin today. And Nadine Flood from the CPSU is here with us now. Nadine, thanks for your time this morning. Now, DHS has said that these strikes will make no difference to the pay rise offer. So why are you going ahead with this?
Well, these strikes are about family-friendly control of working hours. This is a workforce of part-time working mums and the department still hasn't moved on that really important issue. After more than 3 years, they could resolve this very quickly.
These services are already clogged. Just ask anyone who's tried to call Centrelink lately how long they're on hold for. Do you think you might lose the public relations battle if you impact customers even more?
Actually, there's a lot of support from clients. They know the staff are doing the best they can. And while there will be further delays, people are not blaming the staff.
We will see a response from the department of this. Thanks very much for your time, Nadine.
Well, it seems in health news, losing as little as 3 kilograms could make a huge difference to the health of overweight Australians. So we know that obesity is causing enormous strain on our healthcare system, but 3 kilos doesn't sound like a lot.
No, we've got to start somewhere, focusing on our resources so that we can improve or decrease the burden of this particular problem on our community.
3 kilos. Most of us are about to eat our own body weight in chocolate over Easter.
Correct, but it's only a small drop and it's going to have profound effect. So you've got to start small. Gee, you go out to the Easter show and you watch what's being eaten out there and it just makes you think, oh dear, we're getting something wrong.
Yeah.
So cut back on it, eat the good food, reduce the calories, live longer.
Okay, thanks a lot for that, Rick. Time now for the sports headlines. Tim.
Thanks, Lise. Let's start with rugby league and Sharks young gun Jack Bird is expected to make a decision on his playing future in the coming days.
Yeah, thank you very much, Tim.
Good man.
Now, our first cash call is coming up in the next half hour, but you've got to be in it to win it because you can't afford to miss out. All right, time now to get a check of the weather. Good morning once again, Natalia.
And after we take a look at the weather, we're going to be milking this snake for its venom. Okay, let's see what's happening in Cairns. First up, and you can expect a mostly sunny day. Good morning to you, Darwin. A shower or two, a possible storm, and 31. Okay, it is almost the Easter long weekend. Yahoo, and the weather is looking pretty good in most of our capital cities. Brisbane, oh, the pick of the bunch. Have a look at that. 25 on Good Friday, then 26 on the other days of the long weekend. And Perth, pretty much perfect. Okay, Zach is about to milk. Show us how it's done. Oh, and so that's the venom there.
Tiny little bit of venom in the bottom there.
Spilling into the glass. Wow. And all I did was hold the tail and then the vent, which is a nice term for the part of the snake.
The danger.
Just in case,
Happy Easter, Natalia. I don't think it's too early to say it. Good on you. Thanks, Zach, as well.
Happy Easter to you.
Yes, the vent. Now, moderate Muslims are crying out for fresh leadership in Australia, and there's further proof today why they need it. The Australian newspaper reveals the women's branch of the Islamic group Hizb ut-Tahrir has produced a video about how husbands should deal with disobedient wives. Now, make no mistake, these views belong to some, not all followers of the Islamic faith. But when you have people in positions of power spreading dangerous messages, it is important to call them out and make things crystal clear. It's never okay to hit your wife. Never. That's called assault. If you hit a woman, you're a coward. It's not okay to hit your wife gently or softly or occasionally or any other way you want to spin it. It's assault. It's illegal. It's wrong. And don't dare try to downplay or downgrade the seriousness of this stuff by suggesting it's acceptable to whack your wife with a small stick. If you hit someone, anyone, with a stick, big or small, you're guilty of assault. Stop it. Just stop. We have young Muslim women growing up in this country, and they need to know they have the same rights as everyone else. They live in Australia, and that means they can wear what they want, they can marry who they want to marry, and they can do what they want to do. And they don't need these so-called leaders telling them they are human punching bags. We're joined by 3AW's Neil Mitchell. Neil, good morning to you.
But we wouldn't let this happen with a non-Muslim group. If a bloke bashes his wife, it's against the law. This has to be against the law, not in this country.
Sheikh Tawhidi from South Australia, who is a great, strong voice and someone who we should hear more of. So it's a shame that a lot of those people sometimes end up, he's in hiding at the moment because he came out in support of Ayaan Hirsi Ali, who had to cancel her trip to Australia. We need to lift up some of those moderate voices and encourage them to keep on voicing their opinion. I've got a feeling this will be hot on Talkback this morning for you. 11 Victorian regional cities and towns launching a revolutionary bid to host the 2030 Commonwealth Games. So forget Melbourne. It's going to be happening outside of Melbourne, but in Victoria. What do you make of this bid?
Does anybody care about the Commonwealth Games anymore? Does anybody actually go to the Commonwealth Games?
Yeah, because we win. Australia wins at the Commonwealth Games. Forget the Olympics.
We don't go all that fast. We don't run all that fast or swim all that. Oh, some do. Look, it can be good sport, but it's not red hot.
Neil Mitchell, he'll be on your radio this morning. We'll catch you next week on the Today Show. Thanks, Neil.
All right, well, coming up, struggling to find a babysitter you and your children like? We're going to meet the Aussie mum of two who is making it easier than ever before.
And it is movie day. We're going to take a look at what's out for you and your family these Easter holidays. And we've got some tickets to give away. That's all coming up in a mere matter of moments.
It is 7:30, it's news time. Here's Alicia.
Thank you very much, Lisa. In breaking news, flames up to 3 metres high have confronted firefighters in Melbourne's southeast. Crews arrived to the home in Langwarrin just after 2 a.m, finding it well alight. There were concerns people were inside the home, but a search has revealed, thankfully, that nobody was inside. A political row is brewing in Queensland this morning between the federal and state governments over relief funding for Cyclone Debbie. Today, Queensland reporter Jessica Millwood joins us now with more from Brisbane. Jess, this is a spat all over paperwork.
Yeah, let's hope so. Okay, Jess, thank you. An unexpected furry visitor has crashed a baseball game in Miami, stopping play as it ran onto the field. The cat dodged players and ground staff as they tried to comfort the animal in a bid to carry it to safety. Front row seats. Lise?
Oh. Exactly. Just wanted to get a good view, that's all.
That's perfect.
Oh.
Isn't it?
It is.
You've well joined spotted. The dad jokes this morning. Welcome,
yeah.
Tim.
Yeah, that time of year. Now, you could be just as happy as these big winners, so stick around for our cash call. These winners right there. It's coming up in 5 minutes, and today could be your lucky day.
Plus, have you ever heard of a performance painter? Well, we have one right here in the studio, and he's going to show you his incredible skills very soon.
I'm going to guess. Oh, no, I won't give it away. I do think I know what he's painting there. But first, it's time for entertainment news with Richard.
Thanks to our friends at Event Cinemas and Village Cinemas, you could win one of 50 double movie passes where you can see any of those films and enjoy the big screen, the comfy seat and the surround sound. So get into it and good luck. You can enter now. There you go. Free movie for Easter. How's
great.
That?
Get in quick.
Yes, indeed.
You're a good man for organising that stuff, Dickie. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Your Easter present to everyone else.
Well, 50 nice people anyway.
Yeah. 50 of them.
Get in quick.
All right. Well, if you miss out on those tickets, don't worry, because how would you like to get your hands on $10,000 in cold, hard cash?
I'll take the cash over the movie tickets. Oh. No offence, Dickie. Come on, Scott. Don't let us down. Blocky will get very upset.
Where is Scott?
Won't you, Blocky?
Wertella, was it?
Blocky doesn't talk. It's got to be quick. Got to be quick.
Bong bong.
So here's the thing. Remember, if you want to win, you have to register, and these are the brand new numbers you need.
Okay, welcome back. It's time to check in with performance painter Matteo Charles. Now, this guy is good. I've seen him in action painting Sir Richard Branson, and we've got a challenge for him this morning. Hello, first of all, Matteo. Thank you so much for coming in. You're going to attempt to paint Lisa Wilkinson.
Oh, me?
I think.
I thought it was you. It's you.
Oh,
wow. In 10 minutes.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Okay. Do we stay with this live through the whole performance, or do we go
and do other
things?
Are you going to get started now while we talk to you?
I think so. Absolutely.
Let's do it. I know it can be quite intimidating to be looking at something so beautiful, but what's it like for you? What do you see at the moment in Lisa that you want to bring to your page or your canvas?
Yeah, look, everyone has particular features and you know, I see the face as shapes.
So we're going to give you a few more minutes. You better get a hurry along there, mate. I'll tell you what, we've got the clock on you.
Absolutely.
10 minutes, and then we'll have a look at the finished product.
Right now, though, it's over to Tim. He's in a very happy place.
Oh, that's kid in the candy store stuff. And I'll tell you what, he's starting to capture your beautiful smile, Lisa, isn't he? Looks absolutely wonderful what he's about over there now. But let's talk chocolate. It's possibly the hardest decision you'll have to make this week. Which Easter eggs to buy your family? Let's start with the big one. Which is the tastiest?
Well, we do take our comparisons very seriously at Finder, so we could not pass up the opportunity to do a taste test, all in the name of research, of course.
You didn't call
me. It's a tough job, I tell you. Who came out on top? The Ferrero Rocher. It's here, actually, just here. The Ferrero Rocher bunny came out on top, and that was followed closely by the Kinder Egg and Lindt in third place.
What's the rule? If you drop it, do you have to eat it?
Definitely.
Do we have to give this back?
No, we can keep it.
So if I started to lean it that way?
Yep, everyone
would that
can
be a great problem?
Dig in.
Can't, Lisa, can I
it's
do
so
it or not?
It's so pretty, though. No,
Lisa,
can't.
Don't do it. Say don't do it.
Can't.
No, don't do it.
You can't.
Don't do it.
Oh.
It's done.
Now we've got to eat it.
We've got to eat it. And it might just have me in strife now. Please. I might have to write a personal check.
Well, it is that time of year, so don't be too hard on yourself.
Bessie, enjoy. You've nailed it. Options for everybody on taste, on price, on everything here when it comes to Easter eggs, my dear friend Lisa. Sorry to be so contrary.
Lisa.
I told him not to do it.
Thank you, Timmy. You're in trouble.
Right. It is time now to check out what is trending online. And this fearsome red panda isn't going to let a rock get in its way.
In a standoff with a rock. And how about this, when you're two, birthdays can be slightly confusing.
How old are you?
One.
You're two. Remember two?
Say two.
Two.
How old are you?
One.
How old are you?
One.
One.
How old are you?
Two.
You're two,
yay! She started early and shaving years off her age, isn't she? All right, just how much do you love checking your Facebook feed, posting on Instagram and looking at Twitter? Stop it. We hit the streets to find out what you think.
Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat.
I've got everything.
I've got a few.
Doc, good afternoon. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. I'm sorry.
Somewhere
about that.
In the world, it's the afternoon.
It is the afternoon. Look, I know that this might seem like a bit of a first world problem, but it has become a major issue for a lot of people out there, and it impacts other things in people's lives, like relationships.
Absolutely. Like, they're saying that research is now showing that anxiety and depression are linked to social media use, and not only that, but it's more addictive, or can be more addictive, than cigarettes and alcohol.
And if you go to the park, and I've been guilty of this as well, when you're there with your children playing in the park, and I've noticed it when you look around, you go, how many parents here are looking at their phones as opposed to looking at their children or playing with their kids?
Well, it becomes a space filler, doesn't it? An entertainment that's just very easy to access. It's very easy to use. It's immediate. And so it serves the purpose of always keeping us connected and busy.
Dinner with friends, everyone puts their phones in the middle, upside down, in a stack.
Yep.
The first person to touch the phone pays the bill. Doc, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you so much for having me.
It's news time. Here's Alicia.
Thank you very much, Lise. We begin in Melbourne, where a blaze that ripped through a bungalow in the city's north has left a man dead. Live now to Melanie Slade, who was first at the scene at Thomastown this morning. Mel, arson chemists have just arrived there. All right, Mel Slade there, thank you. A Qantas flight from Melbourne to Hong Kong that left 15 passengers injured is currently being investigated by Australia's air safety watchdog. Today's Lara Vella joins us now for the latest. Lara, just take us through how this incident unfolded. Yeah, certainly concerning. All right, Lara, thank you. Well, regional Victoria has this morning announced it wants to bid for the 2030 Commonwealth Games, with not one but 11 regional cities set to play host to the event. Task Force Chair Adem Karafili joins us now from Shepparton this morning. Good morning to you, Adem. This is unlike any other Games bid
morning,
before.
Rachel. That's right. Look, we're looking to go right across Victoria, right across the regions, and really bring some long-term economic benefit to country and regional Victoria.
And notably leaving Melbourne out of this bid, likely to ruffle some feathers. Now, you've been appointed as a part of a special task force to explore if this could work. Are you confident that it could with existing infrastructure?
Absolutely.
It is a beautiful part of the world, and it would be wonderful to showcase it to the rest of the world.
Fantastic.
Adem, well done on your bid, and we look forward to seeing how it goes. Thanks so much for your time.
It's good that they've got together and
That's
attempted
right.
to, and I just wonder what the hierarchy in Melbourne would make of the whole thing.
Exactly.
Well, hierarchy in Melbourne are going to need to be putting in some dollars there. Mm.
Has anyone asked Eddie what Eddie thinks?
Tell you what.
Oh, that hierarchy.
Well, when I say Melbourne, it's Eddie. Eddie
runs
Melbourne.
Of course, I'd forgotten.
Surely
that
the MCG can be included, can't it? Greatest stadium in the world.
Collingwood should host the Commonwealth Games.
All right,
let's have some sport.
Phone's ringing. I think it's for you.
Egg that we smash will be shared around, so it, not a morsel, not a scintilla will be wasted.
And it'll be Are you feeling bad, Tim?
No, I don't feel bad because I knew what I was doing. I knew where it was going.
Yeah. You're doing something very naughty. Shared around
Generous.
The entire Gilbert family. Now it's time for the weather.
Big enough.
Here's Natalia.
And then Dan, get out of the way.
Look at his teeth. Don't eat Dan.
You're okay,
Don't eat
Natalia.
Dan.
That's enough for. We're
You're
not even close yet.
Okay.
Okay, let's go.
Still metres away.
Ready? Oh my gosh, look at
okay,
his face.
Up nice and high.
Okay.
Higher.
Oh.
Higher.
Okay, yep. Oh, wow.
One more.
Wow.
Higher.
Okay.
Oh,
okay, is he going to take it now? Oh,
well
he took
done.
It. Wow.
There you go.
Wow.
Now we go that way.
Whew, okay.
Get out of
here. All right, I'm going to back off. Tim, you're in front. Dan, you're in front, and we're all good.
You're officially a croc whisperer.
Wow, thank you.
Really dangerous job being a weather person.
I know. Let's
isn't
hope
it?
He's not just seeing that as the appetizer.
Yeah.
And Natalia is the main course.
That wouldn't have been a degustation kind of one.
No. No. Not a grazing plate.
Degustation.
Kind of
yeah. Oh, he's a big unit.
I tell you what, if Rob Catter was around, he'd have that sorted in a second, wouldn't he?
No question.
Still to come, car insurance rip-off, the shocking ways you could be paying too much for your premiums and how to avoid getting stung. And the new approach to claiming to help migraine sufferers find relief without medication. But does it really work? A must-see report ahead. It is 8:30. It's time now for the news. Here's Alicia.
Thank you, Lisa. First news happening right now. The search for a teenage bushwalker missing in Sydney South has just resumed. These are live pictures coming into the newsroom right now. The 19-year-old woman reportedly became separated from her partner in the Royal National Park at Bundina and failed to return to their meeting point. A search last night failed to find her. These pics coming in from the Nine News chopper, and we will bring you more on that search. As I mentioned, it has just resumed for that 19-year-old woman. Now, the next time you're in a car accident, you might want to consider giving this rugby team a call. The squad from Japan's Sunwolves Super Rugby team proved they were handy off the field, helping a driver near Auckland.
Oh, yeah.
A mobile scrum squad.
That's the thing with New Zealand. Everyone is an aspiring All Black.
Like fit sumos, aren't they?
Yes. Okay, thank you, Alicia. Sonia and David are here.
Morning.
What's coming
morning.
Up on today this morning?
Big show today, Sonia.
Yeah.
Yes, well,
right?
I've handed over my DNA.
Finally.
I had to do a DNA test. Yes, because we are delving into our family history with Ancestry.com. So they take your DNA and then they tell you where you come from, and there's a bit of a shock in store.
Excellent.
For both David and myself, actually.
Turns out she's part Inuit, part penguin. And also, my teenage fantasy is coming true because we're going to interview Sherilyn Fenn from Twin Peaks, Audrey Horn.
Remember?
Wrapped in plastic.
We're wrapped in plastic. Yeah, so Audrey Horn is going to be on the show talking about the new series of Twin Peaks, which will be on Stan soon.
Fabulous.
Can't wait.
Thanks, guys. Have a good one. We'll see you just after 9 o'clock. All right, time now for your best local forecast. Here's Natalia.
How good does the 9-week pregnancy sound?
Yeah, really.
Look. I'd be down for that. Sign me up.
I think we all would. Okay, thanks a lot, Natalia.
Great job, Natalia. Thank you so much.
Well, coming up, car insurance rip-off. How the colour of your car and your marital status could see you paying too much for your premiums. We're going to reveal how you can avoid getting stung.
And he's the mini Michelangelo, painting his way to the top. We meet the 7-year-old schoolboy whose abilities are marvelling the entire country. Hey there, welcome back to Today. Now, is the car you drive white? Because insurance companies are determining how much we pay for our policy based on questions like that. Let's go head to head right now with Robin Bailey and Rachel Corbett. Good morning to you, Rachel and Robin.
Morning.
Hello.
So it turns out if you have a white car, you can get cheaper insurance. Rachel.
Yes, they've been doing this for ages. This doesn't surprise me at all.
Robin, not all cars are created equal.
No, they're not, and I fully understand this from a personal perspective. My 17-year-old is just 5 hours away from finishing his 100 hours and getting his license. So we are discussing buying cars at the moment. And yes, he would really like a fast red one, or in fact, a very cool black one. And I am sure that when the insurers look at that, they will go, yeah, there's a young 17, 18-year-old who's going to have P plates, and we need to possibly insure him a little more, and I would agree with them.
Crowdfunding has become a popular trend, but where do you draw the line? Because the Subi clothing brand co-founder Dan Single may have reached it after he received a major backlash over his GoFundMe page. So, I'll tell you what, Robin, this didn't go down too well with people online.
How come he was staying at this incredibly ritzy hotel? How come he flies first class? How come he's been all over the world in the last couple of years if he has no money? What, so he can't now pay for his rehab?
Yeah, well, he's been... A lot of people were donating $5 just so they could tell him he was an idiot, and good on him.
Robin and Rachel, great to talk to you,
you
both.
Too.
Thank you. There you go. Coming up, beat migraines without the drugs, the new technology helping you fight chronic headaches, and why 80% of Aussie customers say they're constantly disappointed by retail experiences. Our consumer expert is in with all of the answers. Don't go anywhere. Don't move a muscle. You're watching Today right around Australia and around the world.
A very good morning to you. You are watching Today, and these are our top stories this morning. We have live pictures of a search for a teenage bushwalker missing in Sydney South. That search resumed a short time ago. The 19-year-old disappeared last night. In Melbourne, a man in his 50s has died in a house fire overnight at Thomastown in the city's north. Australia's air safety watchdog is investigating after 15 Qantas passengers were injured during a flight between Melbourne and Hong Kong. And fresh fears this morning that more people could fall victim to an outbreak of Legionnaires' disease in Melbourne. As the great man Timmy Gilbert says, a little splash of news for you.
Thank you very much, Alicia.
Just a drop.
Now let's get another splash, but
a
this
burst.
Time of entertainment.
Thank you very much, Lisa. Well, two of Hollywood's biggest stars forced to call for help at Byron Bay yesterday. Matt Damon and Chris Hemsworth and their families are holidaying together, which is very cool, and enjoying a day at the beach when Matt's 6-year-old daughter Stella suffered a nasty sting from a jellyfish, the poor little thing. Hope you're feeling 100% today, Stella. And here's a quick little look at the fifth installment of Transformers that's out this morning. Another splash of entertainment coming up on Today Extra in about 15 minutes.
Good weird or bad weird?
Weird.
Mm. Weird.
Mm, okay. If that's okay.
Well, stay tuned on
Thank
that
you,
one.
Dickie. Mm,
thanks
okay.
a lot, Richard. Now, coming up in our next hour, we meet the pint-sized Picasso, wowing some of the country's most acclaimed artists with his incredible paintings.
But that's not all. Twin Peaks' Audrey Horne, a.k.a. Sherilyn Fenn, joins us live ahead of the much-anticipated return of that hit series. Don't move a muscle. We're back right after this.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Today Extra. Hey, Dave.
This is such an exciting show today. Mm. We're going to find out where you come from. Oh. I'm so thrilled.